We're going to look at the domain and range from the graph of a continuous function. First of all, domain is the possible x values. So on our graph, we're going to be looking left to right for domain. Range is possible y values. So on our graph, we're going to be looking down to up or bottom to top. If you have trouble remembering which one is x and which one is y, notice that domain and range are in alphabetical order, so are x and y. It's also important to note if your graph includes a filled-in circle or an open circle. The filled-in circle means that that value is included, so we will use brackets. An open circle means that the value is not included, so we will use parentheses. So looking at this graph, let's talk first about the domain. So the domain is our x values. So if we start from the x value on the furthest left side, that would be this point right here, which occurs at the x value of -3. Since that is an open circle, we will use a parenthesis with our -3. Now we need to find the rightmost x value. That occurs at this open circle, which is at the x value of a +2. So a +2 with a parenthesis because of the open circle. So if you notice on the number line, it's kind of that purple line there is our domain. And we could even, instead of making those lines, we could make them a little parenthesis, and then we can see that domain. Now let's look at the range. So the range is y values. Our lowest y value at the bottom is right here at that open circle, which occurs at -4. So let's kind of curve that up like a parenthesis. And so our lowest value here is -4. Our highest value occurs at the top of this graph, right there. And I go ahead and put a dot there just so you can see that value is included, right? Because that line doesn't break there at 5. So that occurs at 5, right there. So -4 to 5. And since that value is included, we would use a bracket. And then you can see that this whole y part, there's your range. Let's look at another one. Okay, so let's start by looking at the domain. Again, domain is x values. So my leftmost x value occurs at this solid dot right there, which occurs at the x value of -3. And I'll go ahead and put a straight line there. I could even make it a bracket if I wanted, because that circle is solid. So we start at -3. Now let's look at the rightmost x value, which occurs at this open circle, which is at +3. And I used a parenthesis because that circle is open. To look at the range, now we're looking at the possible y values. So our lowest y value, notice that both the point here on the left and this point on the right are the lowest y value, correct? And since we have one closed circle and one open circle, we can include that value at -4. So I'll use a bracket here for -4. If both of those had been open circles, we would have used a parenthesis. Now we need to look at our topmost value, and the graph does not break, so we can use a filled-in dot there, and that happens at the y value of 5. So -4 to 5, both would have brackets. And again, you can look at this and see there's your y in both brackets, and we can do the same thing with the x. Okay? Let's look at this one. So here, again, we are going to start with domain. And domain is x values. So at the left, my leftmost x value occurs right here at this open circle at negative 3. And again, I used the parenthesis right there because the circle is open. My rightmost x value occurs up here at this point. It is an open circle, and it is at positive 2. So positive 2 with a parenthesis. And there we can see that that's how our domain should look. Now, looking at the range. Range is the y value. So we're going to start at the bottom of our graph. Notice that there's no break in the graph. So that point right there is our lowest y value. It is on the graph. It's included. So at negative 5, we'll have a bracket. Now we need to look for our topmost y value. That occurs at this point right here. That is not included, and that's at the y value of 4. So we would have a parenthesis for 4. And again, we can draw that line here so you can see what that should look like. Last one. Okay, so domain is our x values. So starting with our leftmost value, it occurs right here at this dot. So that value is included, and that x value is at negative 2. The rightmost value occurs at this open circle, which occurs at the x value of 2. And since it's open, it gets the parenthesis. So negative 2 to 2. And again, you can look at that line there and see that's how it should look. Now, for the y values, the range, we start with our lowest value at the bottom. So that's here at this open circle, which occurs at negative 5. Then we'll go up to our highest value, and our highest value occurs at this point here, which is at 4, and it's going to get a bracket because that circle is included. So negative 5 to 4. Okay, good luck.